Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover how to record audio and make some basic edits to these clips in SoundBridge. Before starting this video, make sure you check out the previous ones in the series to make sure you're all caught up. Before we can record audio, we'll need to add audio tracks to our project. SoundBridge doesn't add any by default when we first start the program. To add an audio track, press the plus button at the top. The minus button removes the track. The group button groups tracks and the ungroup button undoes this. The delete button removes the selected track or clip. The first option when we add a new track is the track type. We can set it to audio, MIDI, or return. Then we can choose how many tracks we want to add. We'll be adding one to start. I'll name this track guitar. After that, we can choose mono or stereo. I'll start with a mono track. Let's start with the top buttons on the track. The first button is solo. When tracks are soloed, only the solo tracks will play. If we press the M button, the track will be muted and it won't play. The A button shows the automation lanes. We'll cover automation again in another video. The next button opens the pre-gain and pan options that controls the panning and level before the track is sent to the effects. The button to the right is used to minimize the track. In the next row, the first button is the pitch shifting algorithm. Light is the worst quality, but uses less CPU resources. Advanced is the more accurate option, but it's harder on our CPU. The next button arms the track for automation changes. The circle button arms the track for recording. The last button on the right sets the input, and it's set to none by default. Now let's set the input. Press the input button to open the window. Then go to external, select the input device, and select the input. To start recording, just arm the track and then press the record button on the transport. You'll probably want to make sure you disable looping before doing this, enable the count in, and you can choose to have punch in and out enabled if you want. After you finish recording, press the stop button. We can reposition the track by clicking and dragging it, and we can trim the ends by clicking and dragging them as well. We also need to know how to change the view of the tracks window. We do this with the arrow buttons on the bottom and the side. To know whether we're zooming or sliding, check the icon in the bottom right corner. If it shows four arrows, then the arrows to the left and above it are used for sliding the view. If it shows a magnifying glass, it will zoom. Press that button to change modes. Pressing the left and bottom button zooms out, and pressing the right and top button zooms in. Then click on the track to get more options for it. The first control is the pitch shift, which we can drag to change the pitch of the track. Below that is the stretch tool to change the length. To the right, we have fade in and fade out, each with a button to control the curve type. Then there's a gain slider to adjust the level of the clip. At the bottom, we have a reverse button to reverse the clip, an invert button to invert the phase, a loop button, and a bounce button to create a new clip. Thanks for checking out this video on recording and editing audio in SoundBridge. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for links to social media accounts to stay up to date on all our new content.